Tomas's favorite colors are blue and green. He has one blue shirt, one blue hat, one green scarf, one blue pair of pants, and one green pair of pants. Thomas selects one of these garments at random. Let A be the event that he selects a blue garment, and let B be the event that he chooses a shirt. Which of the following statements are true? And they all, let's see, before I even read them, they all deal with probability of event A, probability of event B, probability of B given A, probability of A given B, probability of A and B. So actually, let's just calculate these things ahead of time before we even look at these right over here. So let's just think about, probability of A. That's the probability that he picks a blue, that he selects a blue garment. So how many equally likely outcomes are there? Well, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 equally likely outcomes. And how many involve selecting a blue garment? Well, there's 1, 2, 3 of the equally likely outcomes involve selecting a blue garment. So he has a 3/6 or 1/2 probability of selecting a blue garment. Now let's, what's probability of B? And I'll do this in a new neutral color since we're just saying that B is just the event that he chooses a shirt. So once again, there's 6 possible items, equally likely outcomes here, and which involve a shirt. Well, there's 1, there is 2, so it looks like 2 of the 6 involve picking a shirt. Or we could say the probability of B is equal to 1/3. Now what's the probability of A given B? Let's write that down. What's the probability of, let me just in a new color. What's the probability of A given B? I'll do those in the colors. A given that B has happened. So this is saying, what's the probability? Probability of A given B is the probability that he picks a blue garment given that he has picked a shirt. So this, the given B, that restricts our outcomes to these two. And so the probability that he's picked a blue item, well, that's 1 out of the 2 equally likely ones. So there is a 1/2 probability that he picks a blue garment given that he's picked a shirt. And that's because there's one blue shirt and one green shirt. Now let's look at the probability of B given A. Probability of B given A. So assuming that we've picked a blue garment, so it's either that one, or that one, what's the probability that we have also chosen a shirt? Well, there's 1, 2, 3 possibilities, equally likely possibilities where we have a blue garment, and only one of those involves a shirt. So probability of B given A is 1/3. And then finally, we could think about probability of A and B. So the probability of A and B. So this is the probability of picking a blue shirt. So only one out of the 6 equally likely outcomes is a blue shirt. So this one right over here is going to be 1/6. So now that we've figured out all of that, let's see if we can answer these questions. The probability of A given B equals the probability of A, and that does work out. Probability of A given B is 1/2, and that's the same thing as the probability of A. The probability that that Thomas selects a blue garment given that he has chosen a shirt is equal to the probability that Thomas selects a blue garment. Yep, that's exactly. So I guess the words are just rephrasing what they wrote here in, I guess, more mathy notation. So this is absolutely true. The probability of B given A is equal to the probability of B. Yep, probability of B given A is 1/3, and the probability of B is 1/3. The probability that Thomas selects a shirt, given that he's chosen a blue garment, is equal to the probability that Thomas selects a shirt. Yep, that's right. Events A and B are independent events. So two events are independent let me write it more in math notation. These are independent if the probability of A given B is equal to the probability of A. Then we could say A and B are independent, because the probability of A, if this is true, then this means the probability of A given B actually isn't dependent on whether B happened or not. It's the same thing as the probability of A. This would lead to these events being independent. Also, if you had probability of B given A is equal to the probability of B, same argument, that would mean they're independent. Or if we said that the probability of A and B is equal to the probability of A times the probability of B, then these would also mean they're independent. And we know that this one's true. And the probability of A and B is 1/6, and probability of A times probability of B is 1/2 times 1/3, which is 1/6. So all of these are clearly true. So we can say that A and B are independent. The probability of A is independent of whether B has happened or not. And the probability of B happening is independent of whether A has happened or not. The outcome event of events A and B are dependent on each other. No, that's the opposite of saying that they're independent. So we're not gonna, we can cross that out. Probability of A and B is equal to probability of A times probability of B. Yeah, we already said that to be true. 1/6 is 1/2 times 1/3. The probability that Tom selects a blue garment that is a shirt is equal to the probability that Tom selects a blue garment multiplied by the probability that he selects a shirt. Yep, that's absolutely, absolutely right. So actually, this was a lot of these statements are true. The only one that's not is that the outcome of events A and B are dependent on each other.